the dawn, eh? lukt wel, hè?
Ja. So, tell me about this fish. What happened when you showed him?
Well, what went down is I went down for the visitor report, and I was down at about 18 and a half meters, and I saw a parrot, and Saul said that he likes it like a parrot. Then I saw, no, but this parrot is a bit too small. And then I spiraled to look at the back of me, and then I saw movement in the hazy water. I first thought it's a small punzi, and then I saw, no, it's two red stump. This was the bigger one of the two. I banged the gun on the ground, the fish turned around and swam towards me. I waited, and as it came in, it turned, it gave me the cheek plate, put a spear in there, and yeah, now we've got a very nice, this is a very, very good eating fish. You're allowed one per day. We've got one, and yeah, now we're gonna have a very nice braai. And it's just great being in the ocean again. So what we've done here is we've got a red stump. We've put lemon juice on it, okay? But preferably use a fresh lemon. Fresh is always better than something that's been canned or bottled. Then use of this nice, it's like a celery spice, Everglades seasoning. It's like a celery salt, so. Or use of the local salt here, marinara, local sea salt, bought at one of the shops in Strasbourg, and some nice black pepper. Put a bit of the lemon juice on, put your spices on, and just leave it for a while so that the spices, the flavoring of the spices can start to go into the flesh of the meat. What we're doing now is, as you can see, we have salted butter and some margarine. Take two halves, the same amount of each, put it into a container that can go into a microwave. In that you add some lemon juice, right? This is soya sauce. You can use Worcester sauce as well, but soya sauce will bring out the color when you're basting the fish. Put in a bit of pepper, some salt, and in this case we've got a celery salt. Just zap some of that in, pop in microwave, and soften the butter. Then you get in the kitchen what they call a kwassi or a basting brush, and that's what you're going to use when you put the fish on the braai. Okay, while you wait for the butter, pour yourself something nice to drink. Yeah, you can see we are melting some butter in the pan. We are quickly going to prepare some rice on the side to go with the fish. We have some chopped up mushroom, we have chopped up tomato, we have chopped up onion. We're going to bring this to a simmer, just basically get it to cook in that butter. Then we'll add in some rice, we'll add in the green pepper later, and then we'll add in some seasoning salt, something like a celery salt. You can always put a bit of chopped parsley on it when you're finished. What your Japanese do now, they'll take one or two raw eggs, okay, and they'll zap that in there. That makes that the rice immediately, it binds. Then you can put it in a mold, in a cup or anything, turn it upside down and your mold will come out, okay, and then it's nice and sticky, and then you've got the color of the yellow inside the rice as well. We're quickly going to braai the red stump that we got in the ocean today. What we've got in here, Reinhard has just asked, this is half a portion of butter, half a portion of margarine. We've added in lemon juice, we've added in celery salt. You can add in a bit of chopped parsley as well. And we put a bit of soya sauce, that will help the fish to brown up nice while you're busy grilling. So we baste it on the flesh side. We're gonna baste the skin side as soon as we start cooking the flesh side.
That's nice.
So what we do is, now again, we just release the grit. Okay, and then we just baste it a bit, and then the grit does not get stuck onto the onto the fish.
Slow,
eh? Yeah.
So, what are you going to do if someone's going to try and take you right now? What are you going to do?
As you can see, the yellowtail has been filleted. It's been skinned. We've spiced it a bit.
What are you skinning?
Look, sometimes the yellowtail skin has got a bit of scale on that you cannot see, and it tends to be tough on the tongue. Look. The closest we get to tuna in out of season is fresh yellowtail that you basically just shear. So the yellowtail is just going to be touched on one side, on the other side. The inside of the fish is still going to be raw, but it's tremendously delicious. So what you're going to do, here we've got some potato flour.
Watch it oil.
So we take the, if it's too dry, just a little bit of lemon on it. As you can see, we've got a pan here with some steaming hot proper Italian olive oil that we've put in there. Okay. The pan looks like it's burning, but it's not burning yet.
Okay.
Stick your fish inside the pan and zap it in. The mistake some people make, they put fish into the pan, but the pan is not hot enough. They, instead of grilling it, they actually poach it. Yeah, poach is like similar to boiling it. You don't want to boil it, you want to fry it. And obviously, because there's not a lot of junk on the fish, you're actually going to get the taste of the sea when you now eat the fish.
Okay, what did we miss over here? What did we miss? Willem, kom kijk eens op. What's that one?
This is a lemon butter, and this one is a garlic butter.
Garlic butter looks amazing.
It lijkt voor mij baie lekker, en jullie moeten het genieten. Jullie moeten enjoy, hè?
Okay, garlic butter, lemon butter, yellowtail, walnut and something.
Awesome,
eh?